Hello guys, this is Revanth from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 97. Battlegrounds Mobile India has crossed 20 million pre-registration on the Google Play Store. Players who pre-register for the game will receive some exclusive in-game rewards upon launch. Battlegrounds Mobile India still do not have an official launch date. Samsung may be creating a new virtual assistant named Sam that may be accompany or possibly replace Bixby. As first discovered on Twitter, Lightform Studios and the Samsung-owned child agencies showcase a three-dimensional character in a since-deleted webpage available only through a payback machine. These days, many fake WhatsApp messages are circulating among users. Recently, we saw a fake message regarding the COVID-19 vaccination. Now, another fake message is going claiming that three biggest telecom operators in India, Jio, Airtel and Vodafone Idea, are offering free internet for 3 months. Mark Zuckerberg himself has confirmed that multi-device support will come to WhatsApp in the coming months. User will soon be able to use WhatsApp on up to 4 devices, including iPad, simultaneously. Public beta for the feature will start within 2 months. The Indian true wireless earphone market has recorded a whopping 156% year-on-year growth in the first quarter of this year, with Boat leading the market. Although the resurgence of the coronavirus pandemic is expected to impact the market performance for the second quarter. The global true wireless earphone market has maintained its growth trend in the first quarter of this year, with Apple in the lead. This news arrives despite the coronavirus pandemic causing the market to see a decline last year. According to the report, the true wireless earphone hearable segment saw a sales growth of sizable 44% year-on-year in the first quarter of this year. In the market, China recorded the highest growth, while the North America market is still held the highest share. Apple also retained its dominating lead in the market but saw a decline in its market share due to the rise in competition in the market paired with the lack of new models being launched by the company. Similarly, Xiaomi arrived second in the market and also saw a slight decline as well. When comparing to the previous quarter, on the other hand, Samsung managed to grow its presence in the market and even managed to narrow the gap with Xiaomi in the second spot. The $100 segment in the true wireless earphone market saw a drop last year due to this pandemic, but now the segment has been recovering as an economic impact of last year subsides. Google contended that new IT rules framed under these guidelines are not applicable to its search engine and sought the removal of the observation by the judge it was a social media intermediary. The Google noted that although it was an intermediary, the Delhi High Court judge had mischaracterized its search engine as a social media intermediary under the new rules. It has been 6 years since Microsoft first launched Windows 10. The operating system has received several updates that brings new features since then, but Microsoft has stuck to the same name. Coming June 24, the tech giant will announce a new version of Windows. Reliance Industries Limited has just announced that Jio Platform will be working with Qualcomm to set up local manufacturing site that will produce critical equipment for 5G networking in India. The number of active internet users in India was at 622 million in 2020. This number is set to grow at 45% in the next 5 years, taking the total number of internet users in India to 900 million by 2025. According to the report, the user base is growing at a faster rate in rural areas. Even though the internet penetration in urban India is more than twice that of rural population, the report says that rural internet population grew 13% in the last year as against the 4% growth in urban India. HBO Max has rolled out its lower-tier subscription plan that will be set you back $10 a month as supposed to be the standard $15 plan. However, this with a couple of catches, the more notable of which is inclusion of ads. HBO promises that ads would be elegant and respectful and will feature great storytelling. In other words, they are supposed to be engaging and fun, and they will be far in between too. Beyond that, the new tier offers the same TV shows and movies as a $15 plan, with the exception of the same-day movie releases from Warner Bros. Such as Suicide Squad, Space Jam, A New Legacy and Dune. And it's important to note that the plan is only available to the US market for now. PlayStation gamers have been waiting patiently for the God of War 2018 sequel. Since it released, the game was originally supposed to be launched later this year. However, it has now been delayed to the next year. The game's developer, Santa Monica Studio, announced the delay via a tweet, citing the ongoing pandemic as a reason for the delay. On the verge of its 3-year anniversary, Realme held a 5G summit in partnership with the GSM Association. Qualcomm and Counterpoint Research, where it outlined its ambitions to make 5G connectivity accessible to millions of users around the world. During the keynote, Realme announced its goal to reaching 100 million active 5G smartphone users by 2024 and also plans to expand its 5G offering by 70% across 50 markets as early as next year. In a tweet earlier today by Madhav Seth, the CEO of Realme Europe and India, it was revealed that the Realme GT 5G performance flagship will be announced globally in June. While the Realme GT camera flagship will follow in July, the latter is yet to launch in China, but it remains to be seen if the global launch will come first. Last week, Chinese manufacturer Nuvia announced the Redmagic 6R gaming smartphone. The phone arrives as a third model in this year's Redmagic 6 series. If you have been wondering if it will get a global release, then there is a good news for you. The official Redmagic Twitter account has announced today that Redmagic 6R will get a global release soon. Thankfully, we don't have to wait for launch date, as an official website has revealed that the phone will be unveiled on June 19. There is a new pair of affordable ARM-based laptops from Samsung powered by the second-gen Snapdragon 7C and 8CX platform. The regular Galaxy Book Go comes in both Wi-Fi only and LTE variants, while the 5G model gets you a next-generation connectivity on the go. OnePlus has trademarked the OnePlus Tag moniker, suggesting that it is working on an item tracker. OnePlus Tag might compete directly with Samsung Galaxy Smart Tag and Apple AirTag. Currently, OnePlus doesn't offer any device with UWB technology for accurate tracking. There is so much to talk about the iPhone 13 series as of June 2021. To spice it all up, an analyst have confirmed that two features of the iPhone 13 series, both of which matches the previous leak, this includes a LiDAR and a storage. The LiDAR sensors are going to be present in all the iPhone 13 models this year, not just the Pro models. This means those buying the iPhone 13 mini and iPhone 13 can also expect better AR performance and an improved autofocus. When it comes to storage, it may come with the 1TB storage option, will be limited to only the iPhone 13 Pro models. Last October, Xiaomi unveiled a monitor called Mi Fast LCD Monitor 24.5-inch 144Hz in China. Months later, the company has now released a new version of this product with a 165Hz refresh rate and a Nvidia G-Sync support. The latest monitor is officially known as Mi Fast LCD Monitor 24.5-inch 165Hz. The newly launched Xiaomi monitor flaunts a 24.5-inch IPS LCD panel with a resolution of 1920x1080 pixels, that is Full HD. It comes with a 165Hz refresh rate and a 95% of DCI P3 color gamut and a 100% of sRGB color gamut and a 16.7 million colors, and it has a 16:9 aspect ratio. Back in March, Xiaomi debuted the first ever Redmi televisions in India in the form of Redmi Smart TV X series. This lineup is the first in the country to come up with the Mi Home app to manage Xiaomi smart home products. This application later arrived with the recently launched Mi TV 4A 40 Horizon Edition as well. Now the Mi Home app is also available on the number of older Xiaomi televisions in India. At the end of the March this year, on 30th, during Spring New Product Event launch, the Chinese technology giant Xiaomi unveiled its new visual identity that includes a redesigned logo and a new typography. Now the company has started replacing the old logo with the new one at Mi Home stores. Today, HMD Global officially confirmed that it will be announcing a new smartphone named the Nokia C20 Plus at 10 a.m. on June 11th in China. The company has also shared a render of the phone to showcase its rear design. Indeed, it was a musical hearing. A judge of the Delhi High Court on Thursday remarked about the incident of songs of Juhi Chawla movies sung by a man during the hearing of a petition against the 5G technology. Justice C. Harishankar, who had recused himself for hearing Bollywood actress' lawsuit, said thankfully he did not have to hear her matter. The Wednesday's incident came for discussion during the hearing of a case relating to Yoga Guru Ramdev's statement against allopathy medicines. At the fag end of the hearing on Yoga Guru's matter, Justice Shankar made the remarks and said that now he wishes to see how today's proceedings will be reported in the press. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.